Now we come to the tricky part, that is our toddlers and kids. Now many of our kids are fuzzy eaters, you know, and parents are really worried what to do, how to make them eat right. And so today we're going to share some tips and tricks that work. Number one that we can try is keep only healthy food options available. Now this means that our fridges should be stocked with only veggies and fruits, maybe dry fruits and all natural ingredients, you know, rather than having what we tell our, you know, that we must avoid stocking any cold drinks and chocolates and sweets and things like this inside the fridge. Maida and sugar has to be avoided at all costs, you know. So keep only healthy food options available. If what is available, all the options are healthy, they will choose something out of it. So you'll be more or less happy with the choice that they have made. So as parents, it is our responsibility that we keep only healthy food options available and do not stock your fridge with things like, you know, chocolates and cold drinks and just empty calories and hardly any nutrition. And it's a bad trendsetter, you know, that you put them on the wrong track and then they'll have a craving for it more and more. The other thing we tell you is about involving the children in the whole process of food preparation. You know, like if you have small kids and they have this habit of, you know, making paintings or drawings that they call it. They may call it painting or drawing, but you actually look at it, most of the times it's going to be something scribbled, maybe a circle, a scale, a stick down with two more sticks. You know, this is mommy, this is papa, this is me. But they are very possessive about these paintings. You know, even if accidentally you happen to misplace them or throw it away, oh, you threw my painting, you know, it's like, you know, all over the thing. So there's a sense of belonging because they were involved in the whole process. So it may not be a great painting but for them it is no less than a Picasso painting. So the same trick can be used when it comes to food, you know. So even very small kids can be involved in the whole process of food preparation, you know, like when you're going to buy the fruits or veggies, you know, you keep discussing, start involving them, what they're going to buy, what they're going to select. Take them along with you when you go to buy vegetables, fruits. Help them pick up things there. Help them carry them back. Even very small kids can do certain things. You know, you can give them fruits and vegetables to wash. They will relish the work also and they will feel bonded with the food also. They can arrange the food in the refrigerator. Slightly older kids can help you in, you know, actually preparing the food. Maybe in helping in some way while cutting the vegetables or in the actual preparation of the food. If not, even at this stage, the joining later, you know, maybe you can involve them when you are arranging the plates, you know, and see how you can arrange it beautifully, or serving the plates on the table, arranging water, arranging the food on the table. So all this means a lot, you know, when they are involved in different stages of the food preparation. You know, they feel more belonging to it and they are less likely to react in a disrespectful manner, you know. All of us have some point of time, you know, went through a phase, you know, we slogged so much, made so much of food, so much of love and affection and time gone into it, and you suddenly, you know, put it in front of kids and say, oh, I don't want to eat this. And it really hurts us bad. But the point is that they feel very disconnected from the food and they can easily say, you know, I don't want to eat it. But if they have been involved and associated with the various steps of the preparation of the food, we are less likely to face such reactions, you know, and more or less they have a sort of bonding for the food already because they have also put in their amount of food. The third step we come to is what is our food ritual or what is the process that we have created around the food. So food by itself is something very important and it should be had as a process by itself, you know. You need not have food while watching TV or you need not have food while, you know, watching a cartoon on the mobile or something like this. You know? It may sound convenient, but no, that's not the way it taught. So food by itself is a process. When you're together eating the food, we have this small tradition that we follow at home. You know, we have this prayer in various languages. All of us have it in India. Anna hai purna brahma. Prayer basically says that this food is going to make us healthy, wealthy and strong. We go one step further, you know, and we try to visualize and thank all the people who were involved in growing the food. That's from the farmer, the supply chain, the person who cooked the food, the person who served the food, and for toddlers, even the person who is feeding them. So a sense of gratitude comes in, you know, that so many people have done so much thing for that food to land in your plate and taste like this at this point of time. And please keep all the criticism, frustrations, anger, punishments away when it is your dinner time, you know. When it is lunch time, dinner time, it has to be only positive thoughts, healthy food, and that's it. Now, many times parents tell us ki, you know, main kitna bolti hun, sunte hi nahi bachche. So the fact is that children have very strong mirroring neurons. They may not listen to us, but they are copying us all the time, you know, they are looking at us. So if we eat healthy, they are bound to pick up our habits and start eating healthy. So in a nutshell, eat healthy yourself, keep only healthy options available, and let us involve our kids in the whole process of food making. This can make them feel more connected, more respectful towards the food, and adopt a healthy lifestyle. Thank you.